The Honourable Member for Rivière-des-Mille-Îles.
My mental assessment agency confirmed that the agency will face $13 million in cuts next year. That's 43% of its budget gone. That's one-third of its staff gone. This agency's job is to look into potentially harmful policies and projects before they get the green light. Mr. Speaker, this government has abandoned environmental protection. How can the agency do its job properly with huge cuts to staff and programs?
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary.
Our government is taking concrete action to protect Canada's environment. With regard to the Canadian Environmental Assessment Agency, Budget 2007 provided $11 million in additional funding for the agency to take on more responsibilities related to the review of major resource projects. The agency was one of six departments funded to deliver on a new government mandate to improve the regulatory process for major resource projects. The funding was time-limited so that the government could assess at the end of the 5 years whether it was generating the intended results. We look forward to the findings of this committee.
The Honourable Member for Rivière-des-Mille-Îles. Mr. Speaker, the Canadian Environmental Assessment Agency plays a vital role. There's $500 billion in planned projects affecting natural resources, and yet the government is choking the agency off, the very agency that oversees these very projects. Now, the leaders of the agency are concerned about the workload. Is this government's economic forecast wrong, or do they prefer to allow the industry to operate heedless of the environment? The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary.
Mr. Speaker, as I said, we provided additional funding to this agency in Budget 2007. It was a five-year funding process, which we are reviewing right now, and we look forward to the committee's findings.
The Honourable Member for Halifax.
Mr. President,
Mr. Speaker, the countries of the European Union are worried, and rightly so, about the environmental impacts of oil sands development. Whereas the minister's tactic of choice is inaction, the gap between GHG reduction targets and for 2020 and the reality is 75%. Mr. Speaker, why isn't the minister focusing on achieving these reduction targets instead of working against a European fuel quality directive? The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary of the Minister of Resources.
In Canadian economy and Canadian jobs and the environment at the same time. We're committed to working with all levels of government and industry to ensure that the oil sands are developed in an environmentally and economically sustainable manner. They are a strategic resource in our country. The currently 390,000 jobs in this country are tied and supported to oil sands development. I wish that the opposition would join with us in supporting Canadian jobs, supporting the Canadian economy, and helping us move ahead in the future.
Honourable Member for Halifax.
Mr. Speaker, it's no wonder, it's no surprise that this government's in denial, but the facts are clear. The government has failed to properly understand and regulate the environmental impacts of oil sands development. They've weakened their climate change targets by 90% since 2007, and its inaction has given Canada a black eye on the world stage. When will this government take climate change seriously at home instead of attacking our allies abroad?
Parliamentary Secretary.
Well, Mr. Speaker, as I've said, we're protecting the Canadian economy, the Canadian environment, but one of the things that really concerns me is how the NDP themselves do not seem to be able to be united in any of these issues. We've heard them contradict each other on the shipbuilding process. We've heard them contradicting each other on the merit of Supreme Court justices. We've heard them contradict each other on marketing freedom for Western Canadian farmers. We've heard them contradict each other in terms of the mergers with the Liberals. And so, Mr. Speaker, the opposition does not have credibility on this issue. We will continue to represent Canada. The Canadian economy will continue to build that, and we look forward to a bright future.
The Honourable Member for York.